So, and then, which is a good thing because, I mean, God got him out of my life because, you know, but the whole thing for me to meeting him was to give him my Arabic Bible. And I knew that from the beginning. I knew it because God kept on talking to me, saying, Heather, go get this man the Arabic Bible. And I ignored it, ignored it, ignored it. As long as I could ignore it, it would not go back. It would not come back. You know, like, it would not go away. It was insane until I absolutely did it. And the thing of it is, it's like a, it's a really dramatic story, but it's not really. I mean, you all might think, oh my God, well, she's crazy. Anyway, so I kept on putting it off. I kept on putting it off. And then one day I was in Goodwill and I was scanning the book. Just scanning it, and I saw an Arabic book up there. I was like, oh, let me get it, you know. And then I brought it back, and I was having the relationship with the guy that was overseas, like a friendship. And I mean, I did meet him, and I did have sex and not be married. Kids, I do not suggest that. There's a reason why God makes you like that. Makes it. It's just don't do it. And So anyway, I met him in Dubai, and he was just like amazing. Like it was the first time I ever felt love, like a real person loved me, you know? And I was like, wow, this is how men act when they love you. And I was like, I had never experienced it because I had always been the one that was in love with them, and they didn't want to reciprocate it. So, you know, and I was a B word, and he was like, okay. He's from Yemen. They don't have money. I pay for everything. He gets there, and